Welcome back, you beautiful people. Thank you for stopping by. This is a dude with a brew. Stopping by today, as I've done in the past in the most recent beer review number 5, we went over Omegang's 3 philosophers. We talked about leadership and why I think that leadership isn't a delusion, you know. And you may disagree with me, so comment below on that. Comment below in that video. You can comment below in this video as well, and we'll debate the topic. I welcome any and all comments. Let's be constructive, so let me have it. First, let's go to think about what we're going to discuss today. Ultimately, it's just responsibilities. You know, we got into a debate recently about the pro-life, pro-choice argument, but I'm realizing now that it's going to be superficial either way. We have people that will actually admit to the science behind the actual conception, you know, when life actually formed at conception. We have those people, a part of the pro-choice movement, that are already admitting that, but they still believe that it's the choice of the woman to be able to make that choice. Ultimately, though, we don't want to sit there and admit the actual real thing that's going on. If there are two consenting adults, there's two consenting adults because of this new sexual revolution that's been going on for the last, 60 years. You know, let's free our bodies, let's do things, and let's, you know, make everyone equal, even though everyone is not equal. Everyone has their own traits and their own characteristics and their own strengths that make them unique, and that's what we should focus on. But we don't want to focus on that. We want to try to be equal in everything. Thus, we have this sexual revolution going on where we have men and women going around and sleeping with each other and sleeping with multiple partners, and then they don't want to deal with the consequence of that type of relationship. And yes, it sounds like I'm calling a baby a consequence, but whenever you're actually not in a relationship that's loving and you have sex and you decide to go through with that act because you feel like it's freeing your body and you have a baby, that is a consequence. Two consenting adults are doing this, and now they don't want to deal with the issue because they would rather just have all the good benefits of the sexual revolution, but they don't want to have any of the actual responsibility. Yes, babies can be brought up into a financial hardship, and me and my family go through that as we are getting more mature. We're learning how to deal with the things that we have to deal with, but it doesn't give me or my wife the right to kill our kids because we don't want to deal with the financial burden of raising them. We loved each other, so guess what? We came together, we got married, and we had our kid, our second kid, and then our third kid. So, and I'm not saying that we're perfect, but I'm just saying maybe if we have an actual foundation of a good relationship, we'll have less people thinking that murder is the way to go. Then we have that argument we have, you know, where someone will say, because you're a man, you can't say what the woman is going through. And ultimately, we're still not addressing the problem. We're not addressing the fact that we're not teaching our kids and we're not teaching the people that we're around that you need to handle the responsibility as adults. You sleep with somebody, you stay with them, and you take care of that kid. Or even at minimum, you sit there, you sleep with somebody, you take care of that kid, you provide for them financially if you don't want to stay with that person. But murder is not the answer. I know this is a drastic way to look at it, but if we can justify killing unborn babies because financial hardship, possibility of disease, what happens if the state decides that we can now kill people that are mentally in need of help? What happens if those people that are labeled different than us, that don't meet a certain intellectual standard, are labeled as a financial burden on the state? Should we be able to kill them? Some people would actually probably argue and say, yes, you should. But where does that standard come from? Where does that morality come from? I don't know. So we're going to have this, and then we're going to have this whole cop-out that I will say is a cop-out, and I actually think it's the best option because If we leave it up to each individual state in the country that I currently reside in, then the states will have the choice. Some people say it's a cop-out because, that's just, allowing a state to say their people can't do it, but other states can. I don't want another state to tell me what we can do when we have elected officials of our own that if we disagree with those elected officials, we, elect them out of office. That's how it works. So yes, it is a cop-out. It doesn't have any actual standing on the agreement, but maybe, we could actually come together as states and make a change instead of having to wait for the Supreme Court to either overturn Roe versus Wade or uphold Roe versus Wade. You know how it's going to go, though. They're going to probably uphold it because it's a way to actually control the population. And that sounds like one of those conspiracy theories that people spout over and over again, but hey, that's the ability for what it is. Now let us go on. Let us cut that off there. I will continue to rant about that later in another beer review. As we go on to this four-part series, on to our second part of the actual Omagong beer series that we're going to be doing. This is from the Omagong Brewing Company in Cooperstown, New York. It's a Heineken farmhouse saison ale with saison or saison ale with spices. But let me start off with simply saying that the Omagong Brewing Company does not share the views that I have in my discussions. They make delicious beer, and I review it. That's all I'm doing. So, but they do not share my pro-life, my pro-choice views. They share their own views, and if they speak out against what I say or speak out for what I say, that's up to them. It's not me. So, as we already said, Omagong, favorite beer company. It's very, very clear label right there. You can see what it says. Let's go over there. This one recommends that you serve it at a colder temperature. The last one we were serving at 50 degrees. It has 7.7 alcohol by volume. Go to omagong.com. Let us go to the website right now. Let's go back to Omagong website. Omagong. Click on a magical Google. Our beer. I am 21. Year round. We're going to click on Heineken for today's beer. So it's omagong.com/beerinfo/Heineken. Belgian style farmhouse saison inspired by traditional. You guys can read. I'm not going to insult you. Our specs: ABV 7.7, IBU 24, or original gravity 16.3. You can click on the other things right there, their awards and what kind of profile you'll get. So, 2-row pale malt, barley, flaked corn, hops, Styrian Golding, and Spalter Select, spices, sweet orange peel, coriander, ginger, grains of paradise, house yeast, adding notes, bottle conditioned, and you can get this year round. It's a beautiful beer, it tastes delicious. And let us get back to the video. That website was pretty interesting. Omagong.com. The label on here is not really that interesting. It has a boat and two people on it. And honestly, it looks like they're going across a waterway with a glass of the beer in their hand, almost looking like they're searching. But if you notice real quickly right here, though, if you look, if it'll focus for us, right there, it almost looks like they're going across the waterfall. So I got to look up Heineken and see what it says. Let us open this bottle and see what kind of actual color that we have for this Heineken. The colder version of this, it was fine. It tasted okay. But let us get that pour. I tried to polish the glass for you guys today. Nice golden color. And I'm ruining it right now, but I like a head on my beer. Very light. Look at that color. Look at that carbonation. Just look at that beauty that you can see within that glass. Yep, the glass that I use right now, the carbonation is going down towards the center. You can really smell the spices that are in there. Can find that list of what ingredients they will share with you on their website at omagong.com. Aroma, very pleasing. It's going to get a 6 out of 10. Before we go on to the actual flavor, we're going to say that appeal right here, another 6 out of 10. We're at a 12 out of 20 so far. That is very, very pleasant. I'm going to give another flavor rating of a 9 out of 10. So we had 12 out of 20 plus a 9. We got a 21 out of 30. Not a bad rating for this beer. I would say drink it at the degree temperature that they give it to, because that little bit of cold that you can get when you pull it right out of the fridge, just it hinders it just a little bit aromatically, and also hinders it with the flavors that you get, the flavor profile. Very light. Spices are very well balanced. That's pretty much it. So, hey, as always, I'd like to thank you for stopping by. Drink in moderation. May God bless you and your families. Please like, comment, and subscribe to this video. And, hey, guys, I love you. So, I'll see you guys next week. As always, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Hit that like button. Have a wonderful day, everyone.